So I'm really happy to be here. I would like to start with what our former president, beloved president, Dr. Abdul Kalam, wanted us to dream for. To dream for a developed India, right? Developed India, right? Obviously,
to be in a developed India, everybody should have a job, right? Do you agree? Top 10% of India alone cannot make us a developed country. We have to take the whole country with us, right? Only then we can become a developed India, right? So one of the requirements for that is to give jobs to all our children, right? Now, if our students don't study properly, don't get good education, how will they get jobs? Okay? That's how our work began. How do we address this problem? Our students don't have access to good teachers. So we came up with a solution. We said, can we provide educational content suitable for self-learning? We said, fine, if you want to do this, how would we do this? How would we go about making our content suitable for self-learning? We got the idea from our movies. One of the biggest movie industries in the world is in India. What does one do for a movie? What is a prerequisite for a movie? They look for a script. So we said, our educational content, our videos, will also be scripted. It will not be extempore, but it will be scripted. Script has to be written, and the script has to pass by a novice, a beginner. A beginner has to go through the entire script and certify, yes, I can understand every one of the commands, every one of the lines. Only then we accept it, thereby making it suitable for self-learning. I'm going to show you, out of that came a spoken tutorial. We call it spoken tutorial. Let me play one. Here is a sample.
In this tutorial, I shall explain how...
Okay, let me play it again.
Welcome to the spoken tutorial on embedding mathematics in TEDxSpeak. In this tutorial...
It is called spoken tutorial because you didn't see my face. You only heard my voice. So I called it spoken tutorial. There is another reason to call it spoken tutorial, which I will explain shortly. The next question is, what if our people are not fluent in English? How do we address this? But mind you, our students want jobs. They want IT jobs. If they do it in Devanagari keyboard, they are not going to get jobs, right? Both have to be addressed. So we said, why don't we dub our material into all our 22 languages. I'm going to show you some samples. Here is Hindi dubbing.
C++ में constructors और destructors के spoken tutorial में आपका स्वागत है. इस tutorial में हम निम्न.
So because of limitation of time, I will not play the whole thing. But you can see that the video was in English, the screen was in English. Students will use normal keyboard, normal software, but the instructions will be in their mother tongue. Okay? So let me play Marathi.
Spoken tutorial cha creating basic content varil pathat aple swagat. Ya pathat apan shiknar ahot.
The benefit of this method is you can make this available even to linguistic minorities. Okay? For example,
LibreOffice Writer Chitra Niveshanam इत्यस्मिन् स्पोकन ट्यूटोरियल मध्ये स्वागतम् अस्मिन् पाठे वयम् इदं पठेम
सो व्हाई डिड वी डू दिस संस्कृत हैपेंस टू बी वन ऑफ आवर 22 लैंग्वेजेस वी डब दिस इनटू ऑल 22 लैंग्वेजेस ऑफ आवर कंट्री ऑफ कोर्स इफ यू कैन डू दिस इन संस्कृत यू कैन डब इट इनटू एनी लैंग्वेज सो हियर इज
Bienvenido al tutorial hablado de LibreOffice Writer, teclado y formateo básico.
So, what language is that? Spanish, right? So that is just an example. So we can actually dub it into every one of the languages of the world. For example, recently I got a letter from a deputy dean of a university leading university in Nepal, saying that they would like to use spoken tutorial as MOOCs. Of course, Nepali is one of our 22 languages, and that he cited as the reason why they wanted. He said it was most suitable for students of Nepal, right? So this can be made available to people in Africa, Southeast Asia, and so on and so on, so forth, throughout. For example, we can make this available to our neighboring countries also. We have dubbing in Tamil, Bengali, Urdu, Punjabi, Nepali, which are spoken in neighboring countries and can be used free of cost without any additional expenditure, right? So that's a fantastic thing. So it will be our contribution to the whole world. This is created entirely with funding from our taxpayers. That will be a great thing for us to do, right? If you want to live in a developed country, if you want to become a developed country, then you have to show the responsibility that we can actually help others. So this gives an opportunity to do. Okay, the next thing is, the other problem we have is, we have a shortage of internet access in many places. So, how did we address this? We came up with an offline application that anybody can come and say, anybody, I won't even know who they are. In fact, that's one of the policy decisions we made. They don't have to register on our website. They don't have to log in. The reason is the moment you say there is a registration and login, 90% of the people walk away. So anybody can come and say, I want see tutorials in English, Hindi, Marathi. I want Java only in Gujarati. It's like a shopping cart. They can pick and choose. It'll keep telling, okay, file size is this. Then they download, get a zip file, copy that file into every machine, unzip it. There is a file called index.html. You fire that, then what happens is it runs locally. You don't need internet. Okay, an example of that, benefit of that. See here, 250 college teachers in Mumbai attending a workshop. You can see about half of them are ladies. They all have laptops, they all have headphones. Of course, they can listen to the tutorials in whatever language they wanted. Some would rewind and listen to it a couple of times. Somebody would jump the video, right? They do this asynchronously. If all 250 people were to stream the video simultaneously, the internet will it work? It'll collapse. It'll collapse. It'll collapse in any part of the world. Because I can increase this number to 1,000 using our technology. It runs from the file system. Right? The whole thing is packaged and given as a zip file. And it runs locally. You don't need internet at all. In fact, an example of that is in Myanmar, where we conducted this workshop. Most of the time, there was no electricity. There was, of course, no internet. You can see all of them, all participants, using laptop. There was no desktop. the software was already copied into the machine. Videos were already downloaded. The laptop was charged overnight. It was ready to go. So we could conduct the workshop without electricity and without internet. Okay? This is extremely important to reach out to government schools, for example. Right? To summarize, spoken tutorials are created for self-learning, extremely important. The second thing is dubbing into all our 22 languages. The third thing is we can access it even if internet is not there. We have reached 4.5 million students. We have trained 4.5 million students through this, through about 5,000 colleges, and it is being used in about 35,000 labs, 35,000 lab courses as an approved learning material in more than 100 universities. It has gone through their Senate, Academic Council, head of the department, and everybody. And it is used as a part of the regular program, as a part of their MOOCs. Now, it helps different kinds of audience. For example, introductory topics, how to learn to use computers, right? And, you know, Gmail, and so on and so forth. How to write a letter, how to do spreadsheet, how to make a presentation, all using LibreOffice, which is an open source equivalent of MS Office. So everybody can access it free of cost. It is useful to do well in studies for advanced programmers, C, C++, Java, Python, and so on. And also Drupal, Django, Perl, Ruby, all these things are available on our webpage. Also have niche topics for engineers, Scilab, OpenFOAM, OpenModelica, and so on. And all of them are available free of cost. Thanks to funding from our government, whole thing is available, released, free to access. The software also is free to access. We work only with open source software. So it is possible for us to use what is known as a side-by-side method. Open the video on one side, open the software on the other side of the same screen, listen to a video, pause the command, try it out on the software. If it works, go to the next command. If not, rewind, listen to it, try it again. It will always work because it is created for self-learning. We also have web statistics. The previous one I told you about 35,000 labs, lab courses, is actually happening. In addition, of course, this is another statistics. Who are the people who come to our website? We have 30 million page views. We have 10-minute visit time, 30% bounce rate. These are considered to be extremely good. Okay, yet. So I want to present a fact now. NASSCOM says that there is a shortage of engineers. On the other hand, many of our students don't find jobs. Is there a contradiction? So it turns out a study conducted by a study conducted recently said that 95% of our students are not capable of writing code that works. Only 5% can work. Spoken tutorial is one solution. So we need to empower them. Spoken tutorial is an active learning method. They reproduce every command. It is not a theory course. They have to reproduce everything. It's an active learning. It trains them for industry. It turns out that IT training is only the tip of the iceberg. Recently, we, IIT Bombay, created this portal for Kendriya Vidyalaya first grade admission. It's being used now, as I speak now. We created spoken tutorials to explain to parents of these children how to come to our website, what to click, what to upload, and we dubbed this into 20 languages. And it is available, and already there have been about 2.5 lakh page views, 250,000 page views in the last 7 days or so. Another example, I work with a doctor, Dr. Rupal Dalal, who is a champion of exclusive breastfeeding for the first 6 months of a baby, and its benefits are very well known. She trains about 1,000 health workers a year. She has data of about 900 babies whose health parameters are better than those of American and European babies, exclusively breastfed babies for the first 6 months. And so I told her, you reach out to 1,000 mothers, 1,000 health workers a year using our technology, we will help you reach out to 100,000 health workers. So I work with her. And in fact, there are many other examples. In fact, I would just say that Spoken Tutorials can indeed empower us and make us a developed country. Our project is funded by the National Mission on Education through ICT and Pandit Madan Mohan Malviya National Mission on Teachers and Teaching, all funded by taxpayers of India. This is our contribution to the world. Thank you.